Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. So today we are going back to the PA route and we are discussing how do you know as a new grad which specialty you want to get into. So I remember as I was finishing up my rotations, I was so confused on what specialty my first job would be in. However, of course, your rotations impacted what type of job you would like and what specialty you would want to get into. Let's rewind and go back to our didactic year. So during your didactic year, you kind of learn about all the specialties with the disease processes and which part of the body you want to focus on, whether, you know, you may like GI or you may like cardiology or dermatology or anything along those lines. That being said, your rotations kind of go into play when it comes to actually what the role of a PA is in each of these specialties. At my school, we were able to choose an elective, and I always just had an interest in dermatology, so that's why I chose dermatology as my elective. It was actually between oncology, dermatology, and then neurosurgery. And I wanted to do dermatology. I got that rotation. That was actually my last rotation. And my first rotation was pediatrics. So during my rotations, I kind of knew I wanted to do a specialty where I had a lot of hands-on experience. That's just me and that's my personality. I like to be kind of hands-on. And I always learned better when I was hands-on. So I knew that I had derm as my last rotation, but I kind of wanted to see obviously what all the other specialties would entail. My only downside was that in some of my rotations, I wasn't able to shadow a PA, which kind of was a little bit hard as a new grad to see what specialty I wanted to go into. Wasn't sure what the role of a PA was in that specific setting or specialty. If you are at a rotation and you aren't really with the PA, just take a day or two or even a couple of times a week just to kind of shadow the PA and see what their role is. In certain specialties, you may be with all the rest of the students, so that may be like medical students, PA students, nurse practitioner students, you may be with residents, you may be with PAs, but in particular, try to shadow the PA because that will kind of guide you and kind of show you what the actual role of a PA is in that specific specialty. Okay, so let's go back to my rotations. During my didactic year, I really didn't know which I really enjoyed. I kind of liked all of them. I had a specific interest in dermatology, so I was really gonna wait until I did my derm rotation to see if I enjoyed that specialty. So my three favorite rotations were one, dermatology, two, surgery, and three, part of my family practice was actually a walk-in clinic, which was like a walk-in urgent care clinic. All three of those were my top three. After surgery, I knew that I wanted to possibly do some form of subsurgical specialty. I was at a level one trauma center and the students did so much and we worked with the PAs, the residents, the med students. It was just a really, really fun environment and I really enjoyed the team effort. On top of that, I feel like as a student, the more you do on a rotation, the more you grow to love that specialty. On surgery, we did pretty much everything. I was really able to just kind of, whether it's going into the OR and sometimes being the first assist, whether it's answering the traumas that come in because we would be taking 24-hour calls, whether it's, you know, seeing consults in the ER, seeing floor patients, we did everything. So it was really awesome and I really got to know exactly what my role as a PA would be as a surgery PA, just all the different procedures that you would be doing. Two, with my dermatology rotation, I absolutely loved my derm rotation. It was my last rotation, which is why my first job as a PA was in dermatology. My preceptor was amazing. I still talk to her and she really, really kind of molded that path for me of why I grew to love derm. Derm was actually my first job out of PA school. Of course, as a student, it's really important that your preceptor trusts you. I really developed my skill set since, you know, that was my last rotation. You have so much knowledge by then, so you really are feeling comfortable going into your last rotation. It really worked out because my preceptor trusted me. I was able to do a lot of the procedures. I was able to see patients. And of course, as a student, your preceptor is never going to just let the student see the patient. It's always under their guidance and their direction. But that being said, I just had a lot of autonomy as a student. So it really, really, really kind of confirmed that this is the specialty that I want to get into. And lastly, the family practice urgent care role. That was another specialty where as a student, we saw the patient, we kind of presented the patient to our preceptor. We were able to either assist in the procedures or do the procedures if we felt comfortable, anything that came into the urgent care. And then on top of it, you just felt like a provider. So I really enjoy that because you were able to like see the patient, do the full exam, present the patient, and then kind of come up with your own plan and diagnosis. So it was really nice as a student to have that autonomy and just have that structure. That was also kind of towards the end of my rotation. So you were really, really comfortable at that point. During my rotations, I didn't really have like rotations where I disliked, more of like specialties that I knew I wasn't going to go into. And I knew that would be peds and OBGYN. In the end, I did see a lot of GYN in my urgent care anyway, but specifically those just didn't interest me. Ironically, when I was younger, every time that someone would ask what I wanted to be when I would grow up, it would always be that I wanted to deliver babies. And in the real world, that's an OB. It wasn't a specialty that interested me when I was in PA school. Yeah, so those were my two specialties that I knew that I didn't want to go into. In the end, I guess it's kind of why I ended up in urgent care anyway, because I enjoyed the fast track and I enjoyed like that walk-in clinic, and it kind of combined the two of them. That was kind of how I geared what specialty I wanted to go into as a new grad. I remember as a student, or like coming to the end of all my rotations, I enjoyed all the specialties and I was kind of like, you were kind of overwhelmed. Like, do you want to do this or do you want to do that? And really when it comes down to is kind of what you enjoy. So one, if you enjoy an in-office setting where you're seeing your routine patients and developing those relationships, so then maybe family practice or even pediatrics would be something that you're interested in. If you're more of like, you just want to see the patient, come up with a plan and like more of like a quicker turnover, maybe urgent care is for you. If you prefer more of a hands-on experience with a lot more procedures, then maybe surgery or the ER is for you. Ironically, even though dermatology, you were seeing patients in an office setting, even though you were seeing patients, you were also doing procedures. And I think that's what really brought it all together for me. I enjoyed building relationships with patients, but I also enjoyed being able to have that opportunity to do some form of procedure. It kind of broke up my day where you were seeing really just like your routine patients, but then you were also be doing some form of procedure. So it kind of combined my love for surgery, but my interest in like an in-office setting as well. When I was applying for jobs, I feel like as a new grad, you apply to kind of every job and hope that the ones that you're more interested in, you do get an offer. For me, it came down to actually, ironically, dermatology, and totally random was, not random, but it was a surgery subspecialty, was neurosurgery. Neurosurgery was going to be one of my elective rotations in PA school, and derm, I already had my elective rotation in it. So the thing that was really like the deciding factor was, or every single dermatology job post required 3 to 5 years of PA experience. And I'm like, how the heck am I going to get that as a new grad? When I had the opportunity for someone to train a new grad, I knew that this would be my opportunity to take it. So I did. A year later, I had my derm training and I still love derm, but I still wanted to kind of be in the hospital setting and just see what my role as a PA would be in the hospital setting. And that's when I took my general surgery job. So I was able to kind of do both of my favorite specialties at some point in my PA career. I feel like as a new grad, you think that this job is going to be your one and only job, and it may be, and that's great, but it doesn't necessarily have to be. So really just if this is a great opportunity in the specialty that you know you want, then take it. When it comes to like deciding what kind of job you want, let's say what specialty you want, really it's important to one, try to get an elective rotation in that specialty. Two, make sure you shadow or actually spend time with a PA on the service so you kind of know what the role of a PA is in that specialty. And three, even though you may like to, you could always choose that second specialty as a part-time job. So in the end, it may end up working out. I figured this would be a great video to do or a great topic to do because I remember as a new grad being so confused in what I wanted to do, and you're kind of overwhelmed. You're like, should I take this job? Am I ever going to get another job? Am I ever going to get another job in like derm or plastics or whatever the case may be? may be. In the end, especially as a new grad, you definitely feel like you just want to take any job just to start working. But sometimes just being a little bit patient, opportunities may come your way. You know, what my recommendation would be is if you are a pre-PA student and you are going into your clinical year, like really do as much as you can as a student in those rotations and make the most of those rotations, because you will really see if you are actually enjoying the rotation. If you don't mind going into work. When I was a student, there were some rotations where I was just kind of like, like you're just not as excited as I was with my other rotation. That's another way that I knew that this specialty wasn't for me. Those are my tips for really making the best of your rotations or in guiding your way into choosing what specialty may work. Of course, we can go on forever with, you know, which specialty is right for you, but I think only you can decide what you enjoy. Anyway, I'm gonna end this video now. I think my next video is going to be more of the beauty portion of it. So I'd like to break it up with the PA, beauty, fashion type of video so it doesn't get as repetitive. But other than that, like this video, comment on this video, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any other video ideas or just want to know more about something, just leave it in the comments below. Other than that, I will see you all on my next channel. Oh my gosh, I will do this all the time. Other than that, I will see you all on my next video. Bye.